and Gabby Wilkes here, and they are from the Double Love Experience Church. I love the name. So before we get into a whole lot of stuff, just greet the folks, say hi, and what you want to say about the name.
Hey family, yes, my name is Pastor Gabby Cudjoe Wilkes. I'm elated to be here with Liz. You know, me and Liz go back. That's my mentor. That's
my
homie.
We go back.
We go like back to when, like, before I was married, actually. That's how far we go back.
Well, yeah, way back.
Listen, and so I'm just grateful to be here. I'm gonna let my husband share a little bit about our name. But hey y'all, hey New York, how y'all doing?
Hello New York, hope you're doing well. So the double love experience comes from Jesus' double love command in scripture, where some of the religious leaders of his day, they ask him, what is Christianity essentially all about? And Jesus responds, loving God with all your heart, soul, and strength, and loving your neighbor as yourself. The double love is what God wants us to do.
You know, the funny thing is, a lot of people think we named it because the two of us are obviously a married couple and we're both pastors. That's not why we named it. We named it after the commandment, but people just love playing with that double love. So when they see us, they be like, oh, y'all giving us the double love experience today. So, you know, we'll take it. But that wasn't the plan, but we'll take it.
I want to talk about when God spoke to you all about starting the church and going full time.
Yeah, so the idea for the double love experience is really a commitment to try to blend a hunger for love and justice, which is very much what folks are looking for, and to a congregational experience, to have an opportunity to have dynamic worship in church, as well as to speak to some of the conditions, whether it's issues with officer involved incidents of shooting, whether it's gentrification, whether it's the education of our kids. We want to make sure a church that speaks comprehensively to all of those issues is something that we can present to the people.
So that's neighborhood is got a variety of a little bit of everybody. It's a gumbo, huh?
That's
just
right.
Happening in your area. And what's nice is that you are stepping outside of the box and you want those to come to step outside of the box. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I think the idea of stepping outside of the box is really using what you have to do something unconventional for God. And so God has given all of us, 1 Corinthians 12 verse 7 says, an endowment for the common good. Mm-hmm. So it's about using your gifts, your talents, your training to make a difference in our communities, not just out of a generic commitment to do good, but Jesus says when folks see your good works, it can lead others to praise God. So that's the connection point for us.
Man. You guys, what made you pick that location? Oh wait, did we even tell them the location?
We didn't even tell the people
Let's
where we're
tell the location. I've been talking to y'all so much, I feel like I know everything, but I don't. So where is the location of the church?
Absolutely. So we are located 334 South 5th Street. We are in Williamsburg, Brooklyn. We're right under the Williamsburg Bridge, on the south side of the numbered streets for all my New Yorkers. And I was telling you, Liz, just before we went on the air, the location chose us, honestly. We scoured Brooklyn looking for a place that worked for our community. We did a preview year last year in downtown Brooklyn, right on Atlantic Avenue. We were about 5 to 7 minutes from the Barclays Center.
Wow.
And it was amazing, right?
Yeah.
But that was for our quarterly services. And so when it came to weekly services, any entrepreneur knows you got to stretch the revenue you have. And we couldn't stretch in that neighborhood, but we felt so called to start, and we knew that Brooklyn was where we were called to. So we just started, our team just, everybody took a grid and just started looking at places. And we went through so many places, and this place, it is a beautiful theater. It is right at the bus stops and
really?
The train.
Oh, like, my family.
It's got lighting, it's got sound. We have our technical director, Ashley, here. Like, she's so happy because some of the places were not giving us that vibe. It has everything we need, and it's at the price point we need. And so the location chose us. So now we're about to serve the people, but the location chose us.
So it's a theater.
It's a theater.
And it's yours.
It's ours on Sundays.
We wish you all God's blessings, all his best, his wisdom, everything, and just the windows of heaven to open up and pour you out a blessing just because of
it.
Your sacrifice,
yes.
Your giving, your tithes, your offering, everything that you've given into the kingdom. We just believe God is going to give you a 100-fold for all that you've done. He's so wonderful. Let's open up.